Hi guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Janie if you're new here. So in today's video, I'm going to be trying to see if I can lose my mom belly in just 1 week. I saw Slice and Rice do this and I just want to give all the credits to them. As I'm also toning up my stomach area, I'm also just trying to lose weight in the process as well. I'm 168 when I started filming this video, so we're going to see if I can lose the weight as well. I'm going to be doing cardio, ab workouts, and just like Pilates maybe, but we're going to see. We're just going to go with the flow and how I feel that day. So I'm very excited, so let's just get into this video. And here we go. And here is day one, ready to go. Right now, I'm just starting with some jump squats, going to some jumping jacks. So this is the cardio part of the workout, and then I'm also gonna do some abs. Let me fix this mat real quick so that I can do this very crisp. I do want to say for all those that are very professional with workout moves, I am learning as I go. I might do some moves like not with the best forms, but please don't come at me. I am learning as I go. These workouts are very good for the stomach area, like putting your knees up and just doing a little twisting motion. Very good, I learned. I don't know why, but as a kid, I did not like jumping rope, but these ghost rope are very cool. I don't know why, but I just really like doing them. It's very easy for me, but high knees are not my moves. They are very hard. I do also want to mention that I fast forward these videos while I'm working out, but some of them I was really struggling and I had to really take my time with it. I'm also going to show those moments as well. I just want to be really real with you guys. If anyone's interested, I will link the workouts. I also did not diet while making this video. I just ate normal, but I will say I usually check the calories on my food just to not overeat as well. Let's move on to the abs and waist. I was using Chloe Ting. She's the best for those waist workouts and abs. I have never been strong with working out my abs. It's always been hard for me, and as you can tell, I was really struggling. As I said, I fast forward them, but I was taking my time as well. At this point, I was ready to give up, but I had to continue. Yay, last move of the day. Woo! I'm so happy.
Wait, I'm probably... Oh my god!
Okay, every day after the workout or before the workout, I'm gonna show my stomach from front and the back and side. I was in a good mood and I was ready to work out, so we're starting out with some Russian twist. I also found out that Russian twists are supposed to make your waist bigger. That's not the goal, but they say you have to combine them with different ab workouts and waist workouts, so that's what I did. Okay, this bicycles, I am doing it wrong. This is not how they do bicycles. Apparently, you're supposed to act like you're climbing stairs, not riding a bike. But why do they call it bicycles? That's what I was told. Maybe I should do some research on this. Correct me if I'm wrong. Okay, and I also want to say this day, I was not doing cardio. I was just focusing on my abs to make sure that I complete this challenge how I want. I'm trying to see if I can lose the belly in 1 week. So that's what I wanted to also focus on. Oh yeah, when you know you did a good job. these ones were very hard for me because it's just hard for me to balance my weight. But as I keep working out, I do notice it's getting easier because I'm losing the weight as well. But before postpartum, right after, I could not even balance myself. I could not do no ab workouts. It was hard for me to do workout moves. I always laugh at this workout. It always looks funny. Like, what is this? This Chloe Ting workout was focusing on the abs and waist and also the booty area. We need some good glutes. That's also what I'm working on.
You know what, I can't complain. I hope by the end of this week, this whole challenge, I can at least get to 153 or at least 150, because I'll be proud. But maybe I ate too much pasta yesterday.
Seeing that 158 drove me mad because it was the third day and I'm still the same weight. But then I noticed I weighed myself at the end of the day, so all the food I ate that day was still in my tummy. This was the third day I was super tired that I waited until nighttime to work out. I focused more on my stomach area just because everyone was asleep at this time and I didn't want to be the one making noise and waking up everyone.
It is late. It is it's 11. It's 11 p.m. I just weighed myself before I came upstairs to show you guys. I'm doing kind of like a lower, just like ab focusing day.
As you can see, the next day I was 154, which was crazy. From 158 last night to this, I was really happy though, and this really motivated me to keep going. By the way, this was the first time I weighed myself and saw 154. Before I start working out, let me show you guys the results so far. This is what we're working with, and to be honest, I didn't really expect some crazy results, but so far I'm seeing a little something. Damn, Janie, you just started and you're already exhausted. This was the first time doing this workout move. Has anyone ever seen this or ever done it? But this is a killer workout. Very, very hard. Fun fact, on this day, I learned the proper way to do some squats. Like, I didn't know there was a difference between the glutes type of squat or the thigh type of squat, if you get what I'm saying. Guys, after birth, I was very, very scared that I would not lose the weight, but I knew in my mind that I really motivate myself to work out, but still, I was still doubting myself. But when I started working out and I started seeing little results, like I went from 190 and then now I'm 150 something. Speaking of today, I'm actually 150. Oh, I can't give it away. I'm gonna say it at the end though. As you guys can tell by the expression on my face, I was not feeling it day 5, but I just had to keep going. But look at my baby at the bottom there playing. Oh, so cute. These sweats were very hard to work out with. They're very heavy, which I'm so confused why I wore it to work out. But I guess I was just lazy and I just pulled out something real quick. I would say the last day I was very happy, but you would think that on the last day I would give it my all, but no, I really didn't give it my all because I waited last minute again to work out, but I focused on my abs because I don't know about you guys, but let me just say planks are the worst for me. Holding that pose for just like a minute, seconds, it's crazy. Okay, let's see the weight. Oh my gosh, I am 157. All that 7-day workouts, all that hard work, and I'm still 157. But then again, as I said, I weighed myself at nighttime. Okay, but after this challenge, I still kept working out how I usually work out, but not every day. But now when I weigh myself at nighttime, I come up until 155, which is very crazy. Now I weigh 152. I'm so close to 140, and that just motivates me so much and makes me so happy. I also want to say I'm very proud of myself. I'm at a point where I'm comfortable with my body, and now I feel comfortable in some of the clothes that I wear. I'm just very happy, and I'm so thankful to all that clicked on this video. It showed me that I can do what I put my mind up to, if that makes sense. I'm not good with words. But here's the last day. I weighed myself, and I was 154.